Welcome back, students. Today we are going to discuss all the quantities of motion with reference to graphs. So the topic is graphical representation of motion. We have seen different quantities. We had solved the numericals also with the help of mathematical formulas. Same thing we are going to perform with the help of graphs. We are knowing that graphs are very powerful tool for analysis and for understanding. Nowadays, you are seeing the cricket match or any kind of political or economical analysis on the television. They are taking the help of the graph to show the trends or to find what will be the next outcome. Same thing we are going to do over here, but we will talk the graphs with reference to motion. As you can see over here on my both the sides, two types of graphs we are supposed to discuss. First, that is distance time graphs, and second, that is velocity time graphs. As you are doing in mathematics, graphs contains two axes. X-axis is this line and y-axis is this vertical line. These two axes are intersecting at origin O. This is the fundamental that first of all we are supposed to draw in every graph. Second step comes the quantities. In motion, we are dealing with time, distance, speed, velocity, acceleration, etc. Remember, friends, that on x-axis, it is this horizontal line in all the graphs. We are always taking the quantities which are independent. And on y-axis, we are taking the quantities which are dependent on that independent quantity. Means what? Say, in the school we are having timetable and we are following the lectures at specific time. Will time wait that teacher will come and your lecture will start? No. Time continues, and accordingly we are supposed to be dependent on time. And that's why in our chapter, in all the graphs, everywhere on x-axis we are taking time, and on y-axis either distance or velocity. This is the second step. If you are drawing this much also, if you are knowing this much also, then also you can score 1.5 marks for your questions in the exam accordingly. After that, you can see the different shapes of the graphs. Let us analyze all of them one by one, which is also known as uses of that graph. And you are supposed to remember the type of graph, that is either distance or velocity. You are supposed to remember the shapes of the graph and what we are saying about that shape in words. That you are supposed to remember very thoroughly. Last step comes the calculation also. And in our next video, we will derive the equations based on the graph. So graph is very important tool. We can do so many things with it. And in our chapter, lots of questions are asked based on the graph. So please see this video again and again and try to understand the examples, the formulas or the quantities which are discussed in that. Now, very first we are having distance time graph, which is having this type of straight line. So the shape of the graph, we can say that straight line parallel to the axis of time or x-axis. This explains us that the time goes on, but the position, distance traveled, that shows the position. The position of the object is remaining the same. And that's why we can analyze this graph that object is at rest. Same type of graph we are having for velocity against time also. There we cannot say that object is at rest, because the quantity on the y-axis, here it was distance traveled, it shows the same line, means no more distance has been traveled in the given time interval. But over here, this straight line parallel to time axis, as it is velocity against time graph. See, we are saying velocity against time, that means always we will take the quantity of the y-axis first and second will be the quantity on the x-axis. Like that also you can remember that if it is velocity time graph, then on x-axis we will have time and on y-axis we will take the velocity. So same kind of shape. In words we are writing that straight line parallel to time axis, but the interpretation over here that object is traveling with uniform velocity, because in this time interval the velocity of the object remains uniform. We are also supposed to see the units which are given in bracket with the quantity. On this side, velocity is given. So the unit of velocity, that is either meter per second or kilometer per hour, will be given to us. For time, either hours or the seconds can also be given to us. While doing the calculation, we have to keep this in our mind. So, two graphs we have discussed. Third type of graph, that is again distance time graph, and straight shape of the graph, that is straight line slanting upward. So, the analysis of this graph, that object is traveling with uniform speed. How can we explain this? So we are having the formula for speed, that is distance upon time. Here distance is represented by this line and time is represented by this line. I am talking about these triangles. So this line is representing two positions of distance, and that we are writing as S2 minus S1. Where this line is intersecting, this is S2, and where this first line is intersecting, that is the S1. So speed equals to s2 minus s1 upon, likewise we are having two positions, two values for time also, and that we are showing as t2 minus t1. Substitute the values over here. S2 will be 30, s1 minus 20, s2 minus s1, that is 30 minus 20, this value. Divided by time, then we are taking this interval, that is 15 minus 10, t2 minus t1, 10 upon 5, and the answer after cancellation we are getting s2. Remember the units, distance is given in meter and time is given in seconds. So from this graph, at every triangle we will get the answer same as 2 meter per second, 2 meter per second, 2 meter per second. So we can say that object is traveling with uniform speed. Same kind of shape we are having for velocity against time. In this also we can do the same type of calculation, but here this line is representing the velocity and this line is representing the time. So velocity divided by time gives us acceleration. So here we are getting speed for the same graph in velocity time. We can find the acceleration. Please listen this carefully and try to get. Then the shape, as usual, slanting upward. In the velocity time graph, one more thing is given in our textbook, that from this graph, besides the type of motion, these all we had talked the type of motion, then we have calculated speed, we have calculated acceleration, two uses we have discussed. Then one more thing is given, that from velocity time graph, we can find out the displacement of the object. How can we do that? So we are having the formula of velocity as displacement upon time. From that, if I am making displacement as subject, I will get velocity into time. And for velocity into time, you can see over here that this velocity multiplied by time means here I will get this big rectangle. And the product of that, you can consider that this is the length and this is the breadth. So length into breadth gives us the area of that rectangle. And same concept is applicable for the triangle also, that in the triangle shape, one half of the base multiplied by height of that triangle gives us the area of that triangle. So if I want to find out the displacement from this graph, in this graph I have to take the area of rectangle, that's all. In this graph, two shapes are there, one triangle and one rectangle. Even you can consider this as trapezium and you can use the formula of trapezium. But if I am solving that displacement equals to velocity into time as addition of these two shapes, then I can write the area of the rectangle as length into breadth. We can give the names A, B, C, D, E, F also. So I can write AB into BC, that is length into breadth of this rectangle. And for triangle, one half comes as it is in the formula. Base into height. So AB into DE gives us the area of triangle and addition. Remember that here the sign of addition is there. So addition of these two shapes will give us the displacement traveled by the object. It is also asked in the exam that name the quantity which we can find with this, or in other word it is asked that give the unit of the quantity which we can find by the area enclosed under the graph in velocity time graph. So we are having velocity, the unit as kilometer per hour, and here also it is given as hour. So hours, hours will be cancelled. So the unit of the quantity which we can find with this graph, that is either kilometer or the SI unit is asked, then the answer will be meter also. After this two complicated graphs, next graph extra for velocity time graph, that here we are having slanting upward as well as slanting downward shape also. This represent accelerated motion and this represented retarded motion. That means here we can calculate the velocity, that with time the velocity is decreasing. And when this happens, practically, whenever we are applying the brakes to the vehicle or the speed is decreasing, in that situation the graphs will be downward, not the upward. And that's why the analysis that the object has retarded motion, that means with time the velocity is decreasing. And last, easiest graph for both the shapes. This represented the non-uniform speed of the object. This shape is known as parabolic shape. And this kind of zigzag line also gives the information that object is traveling with non-uniform motion.